My laptop was stolen, and everything I had on it was lost. My life's work was lost. Or was it? Fortunately, I had a full backup of my laptop and was later able to do a full restore of everything I had to a new laptop. This includes Windows 10, all the installed software, configuration, files, folders, everything is back exactly the way it was before. I want to show you what I did so you could do the same and keep everything you have now, even if your computer is lost, stolen, or damaged in any way. You need to start with getting an external disk. The size of this disk should be the same or larger than the main disk on your computer. Amazon is full of these disks. Some links are in the description below. For this demonstration, I copied some files outside the default OneDrive synced folders. I created a folder on my C drive and named it temp. I copied some text files into this folder. We will need to check if these files are still there at the end of this video after a full image backup and restore. Let's start the image backup by clicking Start, then Settings. Click Update and Security, and then click Backup. Click the Go to Backup and Restore link, and now click the Create System Image link to get started with creating an image of your Windows 10. Windows will look for your external disk and will add it as a backup option in the drop-down list. Here. Other backup options are to a DVD or a shared location. When backing up to a network shared location, you will be required to enter a shared folder and credentials. Choose your preferred location and click Next. Make sure your system disk is selected and click Next. You are now presented with a summary of the backup. After reviewing, click Start Backup. This will take some time. Depending on the size of your system disk and the speed of your source and destination disks. When asked to create a system repair disk, click No. Once the backup is complete, click the Close button. Now, let's have a look at the backup and see what's there. Here is the folder structure of the image backup. The folder containing the main portion of the backup has the backup date as the folder name, as you can see here. You can have multiple backups on the same destination disk, and each folder will have its own name depending on the date of the backup. The logs folder will have a log file containing any errors that might have occurred during the backup process. As you can see here, the backed up folder size and the contents of my system disk are almost the same size. Once the backup is complete, please disconnect the external disk and keep it in a safe place. Do not leave it connected to your computer. Now, let me show you how to restore this image on your new computer. You can also use this image to restore on the same computer if it was damaged by a virus or a ransomware, for example. Please note that this will restore your computer to the exact date of the backup. So any changes made to the computer after the backup was taken will not be included. You should plan your backup strategy depending on the amount of changes to your computer. To be able to successfully restore the image on a computer, you need a few things. Obviously, you need the external disk containing the image of your computer. In addition, you will need a USB flash drive big enough to have an ISO file of Windows 10 on it. An 8 gigs flash drive would be more than enough. I have a video showing how to download the Windows 10 ISO file and create a multi-boot flash drive from which you will then need to boot your computer. Check out the link above. Allow the computer to boot from the USB flash drive and wait for Windows 10 installation to start. Click Next here. And now, click the Repair Your Computer link. You are now presented with the repair options. Click Troubleshoot and then System Image Recovery. Make sure the external disk containing the image backup is connected to the computer and click the Windows 10 option. Here, you can see the available restore options, the location, date, and computer name. Click Next to proceed. If you encounter problems, you can use the options in this window to repartition your disks, install drivers, and more. Click Next to proceed. And now, click Finish to initiate the restore. Note the warning window alerting you that all data on the drives to be restored will be replaced with the data in the system image. Take a moment before you proceed. Basically, everything you have on your computer will be overwritten. After careful consideration, click Yes to proceed. And now you just need to wait until the process is complete. If you are restoring to a laptop, make sure it's connected to power. Your computer will restart when the process is complete. After the restart, your computer will be exactly as it was at the time of creating the backup, including all files, folders, configuration, and passwords. When I look at my temp folder, I can see that all my files are there. These files were not synced to the cloud, but were local and were restored with the image. That's it for this video. Let me know in the comments below if you want me to make more videos like this, or if you have any thoughts or suggestions regarding this backup and restore process. If you like this type of content, please consider subscribing and clicking the bell icon to be notified when a new video is published. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.